and welcome to Cooking Caribbean. The Rastafarian movement has spread throughout the Caribbean. This is not just a religion, but a way of life.
The Rastafarian religion originated in Africa. It is often associated with the poorer black population of Jamaica. Rastafarians speak out against poverty, oppression, and inequality. Not just religious ideas, but global problems. The true Rasta eats only Ital food. This special food never touches chemicals or is natural and not in cans. This food is cooked but served in the rawest form possible, without salts, preservatives or condiments. Rastas are therefore vegetarians. The term Ital food is rapidly taking hold in the consumer industry. All the vegetables for the cook are bought fresh. Fresh fish is also specially chosen and cleaned. Rastas will only eat fish that were covered with scales. Rastas revere nature in all her glory. And for today's meal, we travel to the interior of the forest with a group for a warap. A warap is a one-pot meal made with ground provisions, seasonings, all fresh of course, and fish. The dreadlocks on a Rasta's head symbolizes the Rasta's roots, contrasting the straight, blonde look of the white man and establishment. One of the more obvious symbols of the Rastafarians are colors. These are red, gold, and green. These colors were taken from the Garvey movement. The color red stands for the Church Triumphant, which is the Church of the Rastas. It also symbolizes the blood that martyrs have shed in the history of the Rastas. The yellow represents the wealth of the homeland. Green represents the beauty and vegetation of Ethiopia, the promised land. Water for cooking is collected at a spring before arriving at our final destination. Garlic. The brothers each take their turn at preparing some portion of the meal. On arriving at the site, a fire is started. Adults, the pot is put on the fire with water to boil. The entire event is a celebration of nature and all its goodness and beauty. Yam is cleaned and cut up. The provisions are all cleaned and cut up. Dashing, yellow lentils are poured into the pot when the water has boiled. Bunches of sides are added to the boiling water. Dashi leaves are cut up. When the peas are cooked, the provisions are added. Constant fanning ensures a continuous fire and a regulated temperature. The pot is covered and left to boil. Pumpkin. Thank you. The yam is the last provision to be added to the pot as it will cook the fastest. When the provisions are all cooked, the fish is added. The fish takes a few minutes to cook and the warak is ready to serve. Well, that's all for today. Be viewing our next episode of Cooking Caribbean when we share another culinary delight. Bye for now.